Hi, my name is Anna, and I just thought I would make a video this week because I am trying to go zero waste for 1 week. I thought I would make a video and share how easy or how difficult this is gonna be. I don't think I can make it 100%, but I'm gonna keep everything plastic in a jar and we'll see in a week how much I've used. I'm excited. I am a little bit nervous because I usually buy organic food and most of the organic food are packed in plastic, so I'm not sure how it will go with the food. I will try my best to go as zero waste as possible for a week and we'll see how much I can do. I have these to go. Okay, so it's day one and it's not going that great. I have kind of a little breakdown because I'm so hungry. I had to go to 3 different stores to find package-free food and I ended up with 1 sweet potato, 1 avocado. I bought these olives in a glass jar, so that's okay, and some beans, and I usually never buy this kind of packaging because it's very unhealthy, so I'm not very happy about that. Look at this, oh my god. Hi, it's day 2 and things are going a little bit better today. I just think that to be zero waste, you have to be good at planning things. I'm not good at planning at all. But I will have to learn. And today I've just had a smoothie, I've had avocado toast, and I think I will do the same dinner as I did yesterday. Yeah, I'm excited. And one thing I wanted to talk to you about is I eat chocolate every single day. Yes, I'm nuts. And I enjoy it. Chocolate is one of the healthiest food you can eat if it's raw, and I think life is too short, so I choose to eat chocolate and enjoy every day. And I thought instead of buying chocolate every single day, usually you have paper chocolate but inside there will be plastic, so I thought why not make my own. I have everything at home to make it except from cacao butter, so that's why I bought this one. And when I opened it, I had a very nice surprise. Plastic. This is plastic, right? I was not thrilled, but especially since I was having a little mental breakdown yesterday. But what can I do? My intentions were good, and this is gonna be less plastic than if I was to buy chocolate every single day. So yeah, I'm excited to try the chocolate. It's in the refrigerator right now. I can't wait. So this will be my dessert. Hi, I just came back from the food store and I did a few mistakes. But I didn't know. I was gonna buy some loose leaf tea, so I found this one, but when I was gonna open it, it was covered with plastic here. So I have my first piece of plastic. I'm not very happy about it. Oh, well, technically it's my second because of the cacao butter yesterday, but this will not go into my jar because I will not use all the cacao butter. I should have checked if there was plastic. I don't know. I just didn't think of it. I also made another mistake. This is not going so great, but I'm trying. I bought coconut water and I didn't think it through. There's plastic. Here you go. Into the jar. Other than that, I bought some dates. Yummy. And I bought some apple puree, I think it's called that. So I have this from the tea. I was just trying to do a good job and turns out I was buying plastic. And this. Yeah. So cute. This weekend I ate out quite a lot and everything went fine except from one time. I ordered a drink and I asked for no straw and oh, it just fell down. And this is what I got. So I didn't want to complain because I thought he would just say sorry and then throw it in the trash. At least I can reuse this one, just rinse it with cold water. And yeah, I'm such a nerd because I even got my reusable straw with me. Yeah, but I didn't get to use that one. Hi, 1 week has passed. Hi, sorry for my mess, I am moving. But 1 week has passed and this is the amount of trash I've produced in a week. I think you can see everything. Technically, this is not trash because I will recycle this. And some of you may wonder, but why do you consider plastic as trash if you can recycle it? And there are a few reasons for that. First of all, it takes a lot of energy to recycle plastic. And it does take 2 kilos of plastic to produce 1 kilo of plastic. And one other reason is that thin plastic often doesn't get recycled. That is the plastic you will find around food. So it's such a waste. And yeah, and in Norway, the plastic is transported to Germany. And how environmental is that? I'm not so sure. To drive a car to Germany and then back. Yeah, so recycling is great. But the less you have to recycle, the absolute better. So that's why I wanted to make this challenge.